All right, we made it down to Brookdale Farms for their side-by-side, their ATV races today. Surprisingly, there's a lot of people here, and you can see it's a beautiful area. I think it's the first event that they've done like this. So we'll have our two main sponsors, STL Power Sports, will be here today. So we'll go up to their booth and talk to them. I'm sure Tina and John, Greg, one of the salesmen, his son's racing in it today. So we're going to hang out for a few hours and at least kind of watch some of the races. But we'll just record some of the events and stuff today and kind of go from there. But it's like 76, 77 degrees in St. Louis today, so it should be a good day for some races.
Area?
Yeah. You live?
Yeah.
Here. Cheryl, what do you expect today?
I don't have really any expectations. Just enjoying the beautiful weather out here today.
All right.
And we'll see what they have to offer.
All right. Is that why you wore pants?
I think she's going to be a little warmer today than she plans.
Smells like onions.
Started the races. We're walking up at a perfect time.
Yep.
Oh, they do have some sales. Happened, the crowd went, oh.
Margarita or beer?
A beer.
We all feel like go to events, but we never actually watch the events of any.
Camilla's Tex-Mex cuisine.
All right, we're gonna walk around and look at a couple of the sponsors and see what all they have to offer.
I sure like this red color. Is that a Honda? It is. I like the red color there. Oh, I like this. Oh, I like this a lot. It's cute. Momentum G class.
Well, we're actually going to ride at 11 foot. Shit.
To park up on there?
Modified the ramp where it leans back a little bit, give it a little bit more room.
It would be, I mean, it's, yeah. It would be all the way up against the front.
Boy, it's nice. I like it.
Right. And there's no 12 footers?
This is their first one doing this concept. I expect them. It's going over pretty well.
So we just looked at
I love the outdoor kitchen back there, too. That's awesome.
What's the company out of Oklahoma? They kind of do the horse trailers.
Sundowner.
Yeah, we're looking at one of those they had.
What's that, brother?
How
are
you doing?
Checking
this thing out, man.
What's up?
I think we're 11 foot 2 inches
wide. Selfie stick.
How you doing today?
Fantastic.
As always.
RV, and we look at the back, and oh my gosh, we got the TV and everything. Mm-hmm. How wide is it?
It's 8 foot.
8 foot.
I love it.
And it's 11 foot from here to here, or yeah. Here to here? Here to here?
To the hinge.
To the hinge. Oh, to the back of the hinge.
Yeah. Like I said, I had a customer, he actually, you know, his tire sat up here, but the bed was kind of hanging back a bit, so he just made the ramp for it, tilted over a bit.
Well, the only problem is, yeah, I'd be right up against the front, so it'd just be too close.
Well,
there's the workman up, can't hit. Well, that sucks.
It's all right to
just
be right up against
out.
The front,
just
isn't
check
it?
Out. Yeah. Well, for anybody looking, this is what, beat Bill Thomas?
Yeah, I videotaped
it. Get it going?
Yeah.
Oh, man, this is exactly what we need. Oh!
Oh, this is nice. Oh. I like even the color.
No, I don't like the bed situation. Does this come in a different, like a just a queen, or you have to do the bunks?
Check this out.
Oh, you got the drop down. Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
What is this?
Oh my gosh, 45? This is so cute.
Mid-50s.
Mid-50s.
The couch makes out to a bed, okay. So you can either run this all the way down, or you can do dumps. Uh-huh.
What's the weight on it? 8, 9,000?
78.
78. Okay. Oh.
This is really cute.
But this is right into the price range we want.
Well, I also love the colors.
Do you have a tape measure handy?
I didn't bring one. I wish I did. Okay. I thought about that as I was on my way here.
You know, I'd be willing to measure. I mean, even back here.
Oh my gosh, this is so perfect of a hangout area.
Yeah. Well, look, hang on. See, check this out here.
When I left, the bed comes down easy.
The awning. The grill that comes
out. Your hangout spot out here. This is exactly what we need.
Yeah. Is it recording?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the deck. I mean, this is the biggest deck.
Hi, puppy. Honda 1000R. Oh, yeah, I like it. It's pretty cool. Look at this big John Deere tractor. Thing's huge. What is this for? Do you walk behind it?
Yeah, it probably walks behind it.
Doubles as a beer.
Well, you know what?
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
It's nice when you can break across and
multi-purpose. We
absolutely.
We buy equipment that does a multitude of things.
You guys can be really popular.
Super like this.
Thinking like that, very innovative.
Oh yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a truck one.
Yeah, it's the Gladiator.
Yeah, I like it. It's cute. Oh, what's this blue one? Is this a Can-Am? That's blue?
Yeah.
No.
Interesting blue.
Yeah,
it's factory.
I need to put, because once I get everything on, I can't park to get the net thing.
Oh, this is a better spot to stand and record right here.
I would agree. This is actually the pit we're in.
You can see really good from right there.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you guys had some friends that couldn't make it today, right now, if they go to Performance Power Sports Facebook page, this is being streamed live. There's four different cameras going with the drone and everything. So shoot that link to some of your friends.
All right, we found Josh. He's racing today for NFOR Performance. Our buddy's Nick, they're over here. So Josh has got a new sponsorship.
What's up? How's it going?
Doing it right? I think okay.
Yeah, well, how long did you work
last night? I haven't
been to bed yet.
Oh, dude.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
dedication.
You see my trailer load out there?
I did see it.
Dedication, man.
Was that the first race?
I don't know. They did practice.
Is it broke?
Just temporarily set back after a minor fire and roll.
Oh no!
It really wasn't bad, it's just heat, but...
What broke on it? Gas lines?
So, when these things roll, the oil goes in the air box.
Oh.
Oh, look at the little one out there on the motorbike. How cute.
What class is
another bonfire.
Bumper cars.
Is it pretty rough out there on the track? How's the track? Rough or smooth?
Very easy.
Yeah.
Nice.
Good.
That's
probably the answer.
I drove over
7 miles. Yeah, we noticed it. We were there for what, 2 minutes and three happened?
Yes. It's a no-go?
Is that just a heat run?
Let's go
number 8, Cody Petre out in Robertsville, Missouri.
Winner.
Your winner, number 8.
Thank you.
Checker flag is out. Checker flag is out. Your winner, number 955, Brock Lawson, all the way from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Your winner of the fourth heat, the Pro Division II. Second place, number 5, it's out of Maryville, Illinois. And third place, 898, Nick Wolk. Heat number 6, please make your way to staging.
So what?
Heat 6, please make your way to staging.
Wait until he's done talking.
Heat 7, yeah. Your 8 and 900 cc's, please make
well,
your way to staging.
Well, they have a lot to announce today.
I didn't know we're doing a YouTube video. Hey, I've got Jim here with Schmidt UTV. I can honestly say in the Midwest, there's no one smarter, knows more about side by sides than this guy right here. So if you've got a $50,000 crawler or a $500 jalopy, call Schmidt UTV. And you guys are Festus in the area, aren't you?
Festus, about to move to Barnhart.
About to move to Barnhart. I've been going to see these guys for years. Between Nick and Jim, there's nobody that knows more. And if you're not the first smartest, you're definitely the second smartest.
I don't like being called the first smartest, but I'll take second.
You got it, buddy.
We've got a lot of UTVs in this heat, guys. This racing's gonna get tight. First side turn, he's in trouble. So far, after lap number 5 is in the lead, followed by number 256.
There is Nick.
Nope.
Did Nick roll?
Number 5, once again, Nick Antonovich out of Maryville, Illinois. He is your race leader at the time. 256 is in second place. Mr. Roddy Lee out of Union, Missouri. Track officials to jump out there and try and get him rolled back. Yeah. looks like number 18. Mr. Ziggy is out of this race. They got him rolled back over, but he is not going to be able to finish this heat. Unfortunately, he was moving. Some tight turns going on. Lots of close racing. We are still under yellow, trying to get this one off the track. Maryville is over as they came around the infield turn there.
Oh.
It's going to put us under yellow.
There's Nick.
Woo! They got number 5 back up and running. He's going to finish this race. We are yellow, green, yellow, green. 2 laps to go. Yellow. White, green, 2 laps to go.
Now,
checker, and he passed. 111 took the inside back in first. 111, Brad Bench out of Lebanon, Missouri. And there it is. He was going to be down to the wire, coming to the checker. Checker flag is out. Checker flag is out. Your winner with big air at the end, 256. Mr. Rodney Lee out of Union, Missouri. Your winner in the 1000 Turbo Mods. Second place, 111, Brad Bench. Third place, 613, Jacob Magnus. I'm sorry, Mangas. Jacob Mangas, your third place, number 613. We knew there was going to be some tie racing, a lot of racers in that heat, ladies and gentlemen, so that was a fun one. Number 7 in the staging area. Again, we have race number 7.
Country Mudslingers. Hey, we're with Country Mudslingers and Chris and Seth here. Chris is El Presidente of that organization, so If you watch and subscribe, definitely make sure that you check those guys out also. But we ride with them, and some of the videos at Carlisle, what's it, the Coyote ATV Park, was with these guys here. So Seth had pulled us out a couple times that
yes.
day. So I just wanted to give a big shout out. Thanks, Lenny.
Not afraid to jump in the mud.
Right. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we'll probably head over there and watch it. But...
Alright, what are we trying to fix over here?
Nick, what place did you end up getting?
Last.
Fifth? No,
he didn't. He was not last.
Running fourth or fifth?
Yeah, I would say you were around there. Yep.
Yeah, he was fourth all the whole time.
Alright. So, you guys are probably tired of the bell broke
right before the jump. We could run.
But we got some more racing to
the
do.
LCQ.
But right now, while we get the track personnel out to the track, do you guys mind making a big round of applause for all these track personnel that are getting these things foot back going for you, standing out there? They're keeping our racers going. Jeremy and all of his staff, thank you guys so much. They made this thing possible out here at Brookdale.
Oh, you can see it. It looks like cotton in here.
Sure. Ramp's
Super ATV. Shout out to Super ATV.
Oh, so the guy said it was the first smartest. This is really the first smartest. This was the second smartest.
Thank you. I told you. I won't claim it.
We'll talk to you guys in a minute.
All right, man.
See ya.
Oh, I was going to say, we're going to go to Moonlight tonight, which is a super hilly, rock bouncing, rock climbing park. But between all the breaks that everyone having, the ones that have caught fire, Moonlight is probably not going to happen tonight, I would say. So we'll probably hang out here a little bit longer, do some more video. We're going to go over and get some interviews of Josh, and if he's not too mad. But he's got a brand new, super nice side-by-side and custom-built Nick Russo at NFOR Performance. It's been putting all the bells and whistles on it. So we'll check out and see what's going on here.
Oh, it's on the trailer.
Are you over?
Well, that's up, buddy.
Yeah. That's racing, though, right?
Yeah, boy.
We have white flag racing machines. One lap to go. They're going to come around that corner under a yellow, though. And 636 has a handle on the lead. They got tipped over.
Oh!
Big sprint at number 11 after a
it's happening. It's right now. Yeah, here we go. Now you got it.
This is cute.
Yeah, we got the children.
That is so smart.
I see about here at Brookdale Farms about 10 years. It's going nuts. I'm trying to do what Cody Petrie did. Or avoid that.
That's good, that was so bad!